And we are back. I'm gonna... Now that we are here, let's go in, put into practice what we have learned. I will be playing the raid. I will just be in a simple M1 killer, one of the basic killers in the game. And this is your stereotypical gameplay. As you guys see. Oh.
Yeah, I got my totem.
Found a survivor. Found the scratch marks.
I'm surprised you haven't seen me.
As you guys see, he's doing the loop. I faked the hit. This survivor is making it difficult for me, so now I break the chase and now I go to the noise. And as you guys see, I found a survivor and now I'm chasing it. As you guys saw, the Fang Min was making the chase difficult. And now I'm lost. And I lost the chase. I kick this because with the chase gone now, because the Fang Min was looping that one area, so I broke off the chase because I won't gain anything from it, but I will go back there to kick it. Keep in mind I'm a stealth killer like the raid, but it doesn't matter anyway because they can still see you. So the point is of showing why when you should dedicate yourself to a chase and when not. Body block. Now I'm running after them. This is a good point. I missed because I'm a muppet. This chase you can dedicate yourself to because it is one of the easier chases. And afterwards you hook the survivor. By the closest hook that you can find. Hi! Hi, you potato! Again, because I had to wait till my wiping animation is clean, I had to wait till I could drop down. Fuck.
Never the borrow time!
True.
Go invisible, Now I'm fucked.
Why is that? Oh. Oh yeah, because you see the scratch marks better. Oh my god.
See, perfect counter to borrowed time.
So, guys, now not only did you learn something from chase, how to avoid the chaser shots, but now you also know how to counter a borrowed time with a killer like Wraith. I hope nobody is going to drop a pellet on me. That would hurt. Oops! My shoelaces are untied. I need to... What the...
Where is this button at?
It's awfully quiet here. I hope nobody is going to flashlight me.
I can't find nobody! You're invisible to me! It was completely invisible to me. Oh, you have that perk on. Shut up. No, no, no. That's a dead hook.
A really dead hook. I'm now gonna do something else. Now I'm gonna try and force a chase with the survivor on this map. But as you guys saw, I broke the chase off early, then I took on a new chase, one that was easier, and then dedicated myself to it. But now I'm forcing the survivors to create a chase for me, because I want the other one also, so... I think. Yeah, I will. Okay. Always remember where you dropped, where you downed the survivor. The survivor will automatically try and... because you got a survivor on a dead hook, and... Why does the survivor not learn from it? Are you here? No? Here? Always look around a little bit here. Because this is a hiding spot.
And I'm gonna continue from here. Oh shit!
I avoided the pellet. That was an unsafe. So you could dedicate yourself to that chase. This is the difficult chase. Okay, you cut them off. Then you go back, break the pellet. Always break the pellet when they are walking in front of it, and you continue the chase. Follow the scratch marks. Listening to how they sound. Keep following. This is a chase that you can win. Oh. And he changed the area here. And always follow the scratch marks. Now, as you can see, I lost them. So this was not really a good chase.
No, we're here. I'm still in front of you. Ooh, you got Unbreakable? Oh no, I healed you. The heck am I talking about?
So this was one of those not fruitful chasers.
I'm really running around looking for a locker.
Hello.
Oh!
And now the chase is going to start again.
Oh shit!
And I did the faint attack, so that is, so you go here, faint it, and then so the survivor was not particularly safe here. But
I miscalculated.
Now I got
a miscalculation in my part.
Yeah. But now we got a bit of problem here.
Oh.
Got you.
Ooh, how much was that at? 90?
Okay, and this is not how you end the chase, but...
Well, in a actual survivor match, you would have had probably some borrowed time.
Yeah.
Since you're right there, it would have gotten me.
Yeah.
Right off, and then I would have been able to just haul ass. I have decisive strike.
Yeah. So, here is another... part. We got a survivor on a dead hook, so the survivor on the dead hook will be extra careful now. So I'm walking around destroying pellets. So now what you want to do is, I did a few chases, so some of them I won and the other one I lost, so. Oh, survivor. Now I'm gonna chase the survivor. Dit is, as you guys saw earlier, dit is dat one spot that is can be difficult. Oh, and I... And I made a mistake. I doubted myself in hitting him. Always expect that trick. Because once you get hit by it once, it is already... then you should know that it is such a location. As you can see, this is a chase that I can easily dedicate myself to. It's
no! Oh, I tried it dead hard.
And this is an unsafe.
Yeah, I did not realize how really short that pallet was.
Yeah. So this was a chase that was that you could dedicate yourself to.
I was running over here to like a loop circle.
Yeah. And if you got barbecue chili, always take the furthest hook. So that you can find another survivor. In this case, I can find a fang. So.
Oh, but now I can die also.
Yeah. Oh.
And I can give him hatch.
Yeah.
That is always also a choice, remember.
Yeah. They can also use your ears to as you can see, the survivor will see me when I'm
now
here.
Now he can still use the map to see around.
Yep. And I'm doubted a bit. Try to get the survivor used to where you make them guess a bit. If you will dedicate. Because there will be a moment when the survivor think, oh, he's not...
There you go, now you're out. Oh! What a tree!
As you can see, this was one that I could easily win. But... If you never should doubt it. If I doubt, don't do what I do. Try to swing if you're 100% sure.
Cause that lunge and that swing is.
Yeah. it's hardcore. But a survivor on a dead hook is also makes more mistakes than a survivor that is not on a dead hook. Because they have a survivor that is not on a dead hook has less to risk than the one that is on a dead hook. Survivors on a dead hook, so try to balance it out when you're chasing. Like you chase, then you stop, or you switch to something else. It's all different. I hope that everyone that watched this, I hope that this guide helped you all. And I also hope that that it will go, yeah, what can I say? I just hope that it goes perfect for all of you guys.
Just remember, believe in yourself and kill survivors. Yep. Let them live! Catch and release! Think of it like fish. Yep. Catch and release.
Yep. Catch and release. It's... so pick your chasers carefully. If you think, oh, they are taking this annoying loop, if they go dead, just avoid the loop. Just don't focus on it. If you know that they are abusing that one loop, don't chase them then. Try to find a different target, and then try and get that one down. And force them to go to an area where you are a bit the boss. Also, keep in mind, Handfield is an annoying map for a lot of killers, except for one. But we won't do her yet, because she is getting a rework, and that is where we will do nerds when her rework is done. She will get her own video. I hope you guys got a lot of information about this map and that it will help you all. And if you guys say, well, we will do more for the other ones, of course. But I hope that you guys will say, well, I watched this video and I'm happy that I saw it. Now I know a lot about this map. So there was KMK again together with Savage. And
go with Chris, yo.
Yeah, and together with Falcon. And yeah, we can. Falcon, are you there? He's asleep, I think.
Oh, could I...
Yes, I'm here, but quite sleepy.
Yeah, he's in Dreamland, people. He's on vacation in Dreamland.
I have to just say one last thing for this thing is to pick your battles as killer. Pick your battles.
Yeah, because. Keep in mind what you saw here. Every don't expect every survivor to play like this, because just like you, each survivor has their own skill level. So pick the one that has a skill level that is either equal or lower to you, and use those survivors to get the ones that have a higher skill level than yourself. Try to get try to put everything into your advantage. Create a chase that you know that you can win, but avoid the chases that they know that they can win. So pick your battles, create your own conflicts, and chase. As you all see, Haddonfield is a really complicated map, lots of hiding places, and lots of looping spots with windows and so. If there is a spot that you say, well, I cannot not handle that, whatever you do, don't, if you can't handle it, don't go to that area then. Try to force them away from that area then. Go bring them to a spot where you are certain that you can catch them. So if they have a generator there and you cannot catch them, let them have that generator then. Then you can just try and get them in an area where you can catch them. It's all giving and taking in the end. And it is like how Severus said, pick your battles. Pick your battles, but try to win the war. So, and now I'm going to say, guys, the following things, like always. There was KMK, Savage, and Falcon. I'm going to say it again. And I'm going to say the following. Adios, auf Wiedersehen, sayonara, arrivederci.
Arrivederci.
Yeah. I see you next time, man. KMK, Savage of Falcon out.
Later.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.